I'm bored, I'm sat at home, the kids are in bed, my wife's gonna play netball, I wanted to make a video. I'm gonna show you a few recent finds, not many, because as most people know, I've slowed down a bit with my vinyl purchases. But I'm also gonna show you a few books I've got on records. And the catalyst for that is I saw Dwayne's response to my 200 subs contest earlier this evening, where Dwayne showed off his Goldmine heavy metal book that he bought back in 1999. Absolutely awesome. So I'm looking out for that. Just before I start, I'm playing Rainbows Down to Earth. And this is a black cover, and my webcam doesn't tend to like this bit. But Down to Earth, absolutely fantastic album from obviously an absolutely fantastic band with an absolutely fantastic singer, Graham Bonnet. This is the only album that he sang on. I've got 5 copies of this. This is the original UK pressing. This is another UK pressing, but on the clear vinyl. This is a Japanese pressing. This is another Japanese pressing. And this is the recent 180G gatefold reissue. As you know, I love Rainbow, hence the 5 copies. Okay, start off with, I've got a few singles here. This is Joe Jackson's You Can't Get What You Want. And again, this is Joe Jackson's AM200, Be My Number 2. And again, Joe Jackson's Hometown. What I've also bought on 7-inch vinyl this week, and I bought this purposely to give away as a competition prize if the winner wants them. It's a set of 5 Police coloured vinyl. They're all blue. They're all in absolute fantastic condition. And there's a set of 5 of those. Obviously, they're all different. I don't know what prizes I'm doing for my competition yet, but if somebody wants those as a prize, they can have them. Just going on to the LPs. This is Nazareth's The News. Big fan of Nazareth, and this is an album that I haven't owned, never had on CD, and I haven't even listened to any of it yet. But I had to have it, and I got that quite cheap on Amazon this week. This is an album that there's quite a few copies of this about. But I wanted an original pressing, and I wanted a near mint copy. And one came up on eBay last week. It's Uriah Heep's High and Mighty. Storming album, had to have it. The same seller sold me... No, he didn't. The same seller sold me this. Climax Blues Band, gold plated. I mentioned on one of my recent videos that I recently got into Climax Blues Band. So I was actually searching for this album when I found the Uriah Heep. And at the same time, I bought this. It's Head First by The Babies. The genre was heavy rock. It cost me £3.70 extra with no postage. So I thought I'd give it a whirl. And this is one that came today. This is Drastic Steps, again by the Climax Blues Band. I think maybe they're not as popular as, maybe not as popular over here. Because again, this is near mint condition and it was really cheap. So I'm quite pleased with that. Just getting onto my books. People in the UK will recognise this. It's the Record Collector's Rare Record Price Guide. I've recently given away about a dozen copies of this from 2008, 2006, 2004, and going back to the 1990s. 2012 came out a few months ago, but I didn't buy it on principle for the simple reason that, yeah, it's great. It's got everything listed in here. I think basically a record's got to be worth £8 for it to appear in this book, and a CD's got to be worth £5 for it to appear in this book. But it says it's a guide, and it really is, because some of them are way out. I mean, I think a lot of us know a lot about our genre, and you know, when I look at things like, I think it was the 2008 price guide had Rainbow's initial first album in mint condition. It had it at £8, and I just thought, my God, I wish I could pick that up for £8. The mint condition copy of that, you're talking 40 or 50 quid. So it is out, and for me, to find out what a record's worth, if you can find it on eBay, see what it's sold for, that's a much better guide than this sort of thing. So I haven't bought it this year. This is a book that my sister bought me a couple of years ago. It's the top selling albums of I think it's the 60s, 70s, 80s and 90s. So that's a good one. I bought this from Amazon thinking it was a lot bigger. It's the 100 best selling albums of the 70s, and that's just sort of a quick guide. This is a book called Vinyl Junkies, which I recently bought and haven't started reading yet. I bought this from my local independent record store a couple of weeks ago for £7. It's classic tracks, back-to-back singles on one side, one half of the book, and back-to-back albums on the other. It's a really thick book, and it's got literally thousands of albums and singles in there that apparently we have to own. This one might interest Dwayne and Rob down the road from me and the like. This is the 100 best and absolute greatest heavy metal albums of all time. And when I saw this for sale on Amazon, I had to have it, and I thought it'd be interesting to see just how many of these albums I've got, and I've got quite a lot of them. But there's a lot in here that I haven't got, so again, I don't want to go and listen to them. I want to buy them, but I'm not gonna just yet. It's not numbered 1 to 100. It's just 100. They're not saying this is the best album of all time. But that's a great book. It's quite cheap. But I am gonna look for that Goldmine book, Dwayne. See how it goes. Oh, one last thing just before I go. I know a couple of people have shown these in the past. Record collector. I used to have a subscription to this, and I stopped it simply because I felt it was a lot of money for a magazine that is mostly more to do with music than records, if you know what I mean. There's thousands of music magazines on the market. I wanted something that talked about records from cover to cover, and this doesn't. It's more about music, you know, talk more about artists and albums. If anybody wants these, send me a message and I'll send them to you. They're quite heavy, so it depends on where you live, but I'm sure we can sort something out. I don't want any money for them, obviously. But yeah, that's it, guys. Take care. See you soon. Hi Vinyl Community, I'm going to Hi Vinyl Community, I'm going to shoot a video tonight. I haven't got very many... Tell him you're bored, you sat at home, kids are in bed, the wife's going to play netball, and you want to make a video. I'm bored, I'm sat at home, the kids are in bed, the wife's gonna play netball, I wanted to make a video. I'm gonna show you a few recent finds. I'm bored, I'm sat at home, the kids are in bed, the wife's gonna play netball, I wanted to make a video.